Welcome to this demo where I will show you how to use the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes with HPE Primera. My name is Chris Snell and I'm a tech marketing engineer for Hewlett-Packard Enterprise Storage Division. Today I want to talk about how to deploy the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes with an HPE Primera storage array. The CSI driver exposes many storage management capabilities of HPE's primary storage offerings like HPE Primera, Repar, and HPE Nimble Storage into Kubernetes. HPE Primera is a block storage array that you can connect to your Kubernetes cluster via Fibre Channel or iSCSI. The CSI driver exposes many of the data management capabilities of Primera, like thin or data reduction volumes, quality of service tuning, CPGs, as well as peer persistence replication, snapshots, and exposing all of this to Kubernetes, which allows the cluster admin to configure storage classes, and ultimately allowing the end user to request storage tailored to their application requirements. In this demo, we will use Helm to deploy a WordPress site within my Kubernetes cluster, and the WordPress deployment requires two persistent volumes to be provisioned during the deployment process, and we will use the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes along with the Primera to provision an NFS volume to back the WordPress application using the new NFS provisioner that is part of the HPE CSI driver, as well as a more traditional data reduction volume for the MariaDB that WordPress uses. With that, let's get into the demo. I have a standard Kubernetes cluster here along with Helm installed and configured. We will start by grabbing the latest Helm chart for the HPE CSI driver. Next, we'll install the Helm chart for the CSI driver to our Kubernetes cluster. This will take a minute or two to complete. Now we can verify that everything's up and running. The default deployment will include the HPE Primera and 3PAR container storage provider that will be used to provision the storage that we need. Once we've verified the deployment is ready, we will need to create a Kubernetes secret that will be used to configure the connection information and more details to my array. The secret will have the array IP, username, password, and type of driver that I'll be using, which in my case is the Primera. Once we have that defined, we can create the secret within Kubernetes. Now we're ready to create the default storage class. For more specific information on configuring a storage class for Primera, go to scott.hpedev.io. In my case, I will set some basic parameters like the CPG that I'll be using, as well as the provisioning type that I want to use for the volumes. I want to be able to use the data reduction capability of my Primera. I also need to make sure that the CSI sidecars are referencing the secrets that I created earlier. Also, I have set allow overrides within this storage class. This gives the user the ability to customize the volumes as they need whenever they are making the volume claims, and set custom parameters like CPG description, or in this case, provision NFS volumes if the application needs it. Once I have this set, I will go ahead and create the storage class within the cluster. With the storage class available, I will create my first volume claim for the WordPress app. I want to show how to use the CSI driver to provision read-write many volumes using the NFS provisioner feature, which is currently in beta found within the driver. To provision read-write many volumes, you first need to set the NFS resources to true. And depending on the app, you may need to also set the permissions for the mount point of the volume with FS mode. We don't have to specify the storage class since we have a default one already configured. Once done creating the PVC, the CSI driver will deploy an NFS front end that will serve out a read-write many volume that will be backed by the block volume from the Primera array. Again, more information on this feature can be found on scott.hpedev.io. Next, I'll create the other persistent volume claim for the WordPress database, again using the default storage class. With the persistent volumes now available, we can deploy the WordPress app using the Helm chart. I'll first need to grab the WordPress chart from Bitnami. Next, I will install the chart while specifying the PVC I just created. This will take a couple minutes to complete as it configures the database first and then starts up the WordPress application. We can quickly test that the WordPress site is up and running. We can do a port forward to check that the WordPress site is up. Since I'm using a read-write mini volume, I can scale the WordPress application to 3 for high availability. I can watch those new replicas come up, and each of them will have concurrent access to the NFS volume. Now let's check back to see if we can write data to the application and verify that it's all working correctly. I'll create a quick post on here. With that, we can see that we have successfully deployed the WordPress app using the HPE CSI driver with HPE Primera for both block and NFS volumes. Before I go, I wanted to take a quick look at the volumes to show you what they look like. Back at the console, I can look at the persistent volumes that were created within the cluster. Here I can see that there's 2 read-write-once volumes, and there is also a 20-gig read-write mini volume here. Remember that the 20-gig read-write mini volume was created by the NFS provisioner and is backed by this 20-gig read-write-once volume. So I can go and log into the Primera UI to look at these volumes as well. When I click on volumes, I can see both of the volumes I created. These volume names match the PVC names found within the cluster. We can also inspect the volumes to see that they have data reduction enabled and the proper CPG set. Finally, since this was a demo and as a good tenant, I will go ahead and clean up all the work that I have done. That's all for this demo. If you want to learn more, go to hpe.com/storage/containers. Until next time.